What brand has lost your loyalty and will never reclaim it? DoorDash. After it came out that the company routinely keeps the tips rather than giving them to the driver, I said the monsieur. There is a class action lawsuit currently against him for this very thing. Spectrum. Will ditch as soon as there is another option. Yep, they have a monopoly in my city currently, but there is a fiber company slowly spreading. We are switching as soon as it reaches our neighborhood. I just ditched the monsieur. Fiber was installed around here over the last few months, and as soon as it was available I switched. Went from 100 Mbps to 500 Mbps for $10 less. Black & Decker, when they started, they made good tools, and continued for many years. They went broke and sold the name to a megacorp that slapped the name on their low end. Junk tool line brands don't mean anything. Product quality is all that matters. And GT, brands don't mean anything anymore, ain't that the truth? Brands are nothing more than badges now, stuck on commoditized product and made overseas by the lowest bidder. Planet Fitness. These towed my car while I was working out, and refused to reimburse the fee from the tow company. Then when I tried to cancel my membership, I'm told I cannot call, I have to come in person or write a hard copy letter. I do the latter, they continue charging. I go in person, an associate deactivates the account, but I still get charged the next month. Took a third attempt in speaking to a manager for them to surrender my $10 a month. Sorry, that's why I put that stuff on credit card. Then dispute any charges after I cancelled. Lesson learned. I just swore off gym memberships entirely, can do what I need with a couple weights at home. Hurts. They gave me a car with a missing oil cap and almost left me stranded in rural Germany. We drove from Berlin to Neuschwanstein and noticed the car acting funny the closer we got. Afterwards we checked the engine to find oil everywhere. No worries, there was a Hertz in this small town. Unfortunately, the owner refused to help us as they were closed and said we have to call the company. This was also late, so every shop in town was closed. We called Hertz and they recommended we try putting a bag over it and driving back to Berlin. Luckily we found the cap and a number to Germany's equivalent to AAA. Hertz. Hertz tried suing me when I was involved in an accident involving one of their cars. Let me clarify that. I was rear-ended in stop-and-go traffic and pushed into the van that someone had rented from the monsieur. This occurred in Connecticut on I-95 just after Norwalk. For some bizarre reason, they called me and threatened to take me to court in Dallas for damages, citing Texas law that I was at fault because I was following too closely at 0 miles per hour. I told him to read the police report and have their lawyers call mine. Never heard from them again. But them anyway. I'd rather walk than rent one of their cars. Yeah, Hertz. Why people would use their service is beyond me. Surprisingly, I've never had an issue with any other rental service, even the budget guys. Dave a curl. I have curly hair that's also very fine. And I'm really picky about the products I use. I can't use anything that will dry it out or weigh it down. A stylist friend of mine recommended DC to me back in 2012, and I loved it immediately. I went all in, and for a while DC products were all I was using on my hair. Apparently a couple years ago they were bought by another company, and the formula for a lot of their products changed. I didn't realize this. Meanwhile, my hair was starting to get really thin. It's normal for me to lose a little bit of hair in the shower, but it was getting really excessive. I figured it was just because I was getting older and my body hormones were changing. I didn't even think that it could have anything to do with my beloved hair products. Then I joined a group for curly-haired folk and learned that a lot of Dave a curl users were having the same issues with hair loss. Countless before, after photos convinced me that I wasn't just losing my hair due to bad genetic luck. I got rid of all my DC products and, after some research, started a new product regimen. Slowly but surely, my hair is starting to recover. I feel so betrayed, though. And despite hundreds of customers complaining to the company, they have yet yet to acknowledge or address the problem, monsieur. They are also no longer cruelty-free. Expedia, they regularly up bookings, refuse to take responsibility, refuse to refund money, lie to you and try to frustrate you into giving up on getting your money back. No, Expedia, I will not accept credit to your service when you charge close to $1,000 to my credit card without authorization. I booked my honeymoon at an all-inclusive resort through Expedia, or at least I took Expedia's word for it that it was all-inclusive. Found out after paying for everything that it wasn't all-inclusive, even though Expedia's website said that it was. They refunded me $100, lol. Nestle, they're making a huge profit off of Canadian fresh water and paying next to nothing in taxes. Californian commenting, Nestle has been depleting the aquifer in one of the driest parts of the state, exploiting federal and tribal lands to evade regulation. Don't forget about stealing water from the communities in me and then selling it back to the monsieur. Half-price books. We were going through a rough time during my freshman year. My mom was sick and out of work. We got behind on bills and lost the house, and ended up having to move into a tiny, tiny apartment in the dead of winter. Since we wouldn't have enough room for everything, even with a storage unit, it was decided that I would have to get rid of some of my books. By some, I mean the majority of my collection. In the end, I filled three storage bins with books I'd taken great care of growing up, and we made our way to Half-Price Books, foolishly thinking we'd get a fair price for what was essentially my childhood. At the selling desk, I made it that I only wanted an estimate and would take my books elsewhere if I felt I was being lowballed. The girl at the desk assured me I'd get an estimate and told me to come back in an hour, considering how many books they would have to inspect. An hour later, I make my way to the desk only to be told that the most they'd give me was $15. Take it or leave it. I was heartbroken and outraged, and demanded that my books be returned, only to be told that some were already being processed into the system while others had already been thrown away, so there was no way I'd get them back. I ended up leaving in tears with only 15 measly dollars and a broken heart to show for my troubles. I will never, and I mean never, shop or sell at Half-Price Books again, and if ever anyone asks my opinion of them, I tell them about my terrible experience. I simply cannot forgive a company that would see child making one of the most difficult decisions in their 14 years of life and not only kick her while she's down, but rub salt in the wounds just because they can. Half-Price Books. The moment they refuse to give you your books back, it's time to call the police. They aren't allowed to process a single thing until they've paid you for it. They would be on the hook for every book they processed and couldn't return. The only caveat is you'll need an inventory for the police report. Comcast. Many, many years of fuckery. Once I moved from a top floor apartment to a ground floor apartment in the same complex, I notified them ahead of time and they told me they had it all set so that it would switch that day. No problems at all. I called them about four times. A guy came out and looked at it, and then I spent a solid 4 hours on hold, only for the woman to come on the line and tell me I hadn't moved from apartment 200 to apartment 100. I had moved from 100 to 200. I explained she was incorrect, and she called me a liar. In addition, my mother passed unexpectedly 10 years ago. My sister immediately brought her Comcast equipment back, and the company said they were so sorry to hear what happened, and there would be no additional charges from him, and the account was squared away. As mom's executor, I began receiving bills from mom every month. Every month I would call and explain, and they would say, "Oh, yes, I see the notes, we're sorry, it won't happen again." Every month another bill would come, and every month it would be larger, with more late fees added. Finally, after about the 10th time it happened, I was really testy about it, and they were like, "Let me put you on to hold, you'll have to speak to my supervisor." The supervisor gets on and immediately says, "The reason your mother's bill is so high is that she is not making payments." And I lost it and screamed, "That's because she's dead." Quote, they put me on hold a long time after that, and when we were done, I never heard from them again. Came here to say Comcast, worst company I've ever dealt with, but nothing compared to this. I'm sorry for your loss and the way you were treated. Pyrex. They became trusted because their cookware was borosilicate glass, which withstands temperature change super well. But now they switched to soda lime glass and rode their good reputation out with higher profit margins from cheap materials. Gillette, because of how expensive their razors are. Old Navy, their clothes fall apart quickly. Not bad for toddlers since they go through them so fast. Time Warner, Spectrum, Monsieur, cable company that does typical cable company. Nestle, I hope they choke on acid rain. And GT, Old Navy, their clothes fall apart quickly. Not bad for toddlers since they go through them so fast. Also for me personally, Old Navy clothes have an awkward fit to the Monsieur. I have never found something there that I liked and looked nice on me. Goodwill, they are disguises as a charity when in fact they are nothing if the sort. https://www.nbcnews.com video. Some workers at Goodwill paid as little as 22 cents an hour. 3417299 5713. When your regional CEOs get hundreds of millions as a bonus, but they can legally pay well under minimum wage because the employee wouldn't otherwise be enjoyable. Their merchandise costs them nothing because it's all donated. They get huge tax breaks because of their charitable status. They have many programs to help the disabled, but again, they themselves treat the disabled horribly. Goodwill was actually my first job. I can attest to how they treat the disabled people that work there. I had managers that would make fun of the Monsieur. I worked there for years and never got a raise. It's a horrible place to work. Salvation Army and Autism Speaks Their Say doesn't help any of the women they take in, and they're just horrible people, as doesn't help autistics. They're more of a hate group towards the Monsieur. IDK if those count. So, Salvation Army, Goodwill, and RCC either exploit or outright harm the people they're meant to be helping, which means all the thrift stores near me are out. Can't buy new clothing, because that's bad for the environment. But I also can't buy online secondhand because they have to ship it to me, which is also bad for the environment. Guess I'll just be naked then. Lol. The Good Place was right. Benefit Cosmetics after there. You don't need to be clever, you're pretty. Campaign. Please tell me more. Tim Hortons, larger coffee chain in Canada. When Ontario raised minimum wage, they took away paid breaks, their dental plan, and started charging for uniforms, completely from a company that makes millions and markets itself as so wholesome they're part of our culture. Not with moves like that, Monsieur. Also, their coffee totally sucks now. McDonald's has replaced Tim Hortons for all the things I used to want from Timmy's. Better coffee, better baked goods, and better food options if I want fast food. By the way, we are talking price range and convenience here. Nothing holds up to